Hello, Namaskar and Adab to all my friends from your friend astrologer and guide Irfan, once more with you from your very own channel Astro Assurance. A few weeks back we did the return of Saturn and what it means for your respective horoscope and what it means for the current status of your life where Saturn has returned, which means that if Saturn comes back to the point where it starts off in your horoscope or comes back to the same house, that it means that Saturn has returned to the very house that it is placed in your horoscope. And we know that Saturn transited almost 8 months back in January into its own sign of Capricorn after more than 28 years. And we also talked about the return of Rahu. Today I am going to talk about a very important return, a very karmic return, which is that of Ketu, which is going to happen this month in roughly about 10 to 12 days of time. And why is this particular return very critical, very important? And not only because Ketu is transiting this month and this year, but Ketu transits every 18 months just like Rahu, because they are in the same axis. So every Ketu return does bring some meaning to our lives, does bring some meaning to the specific current state of our life, and there is a different deeper meaning to it, a different manifestation to it, and there is a different road ahead for us that it brings in as a signal for us. So firstly, what is Ketu? Ketu is a planet of negation. Ketu determines what areas of your life or what characteristics of your life or what results of your life are negated to you or not given to you or not easily given to you. Why? Because Ketu is the dhwaja, means where you have already put the flag of conquering in your earlier life, in its earlier manifestation, and so been there, done that, and hence this particular life your focus is going to be where Rahu is placed, and that is where your karma is. And Rahu does help you bring about more materialistic tendencies of life also. The only meaning or the deeper meaning of Rahu is that you should not be too caught in the materialism which Rahu can bring as a characteristic, and you should focus both on your karma, or mainly on your karma for your respective placement of Rahu and for this life, and not chase it too materialistically but at a karmic level. Whereas Ketu's placement in your horoscope means that you need to focus more on doing it for others than for self, because you have already done the respective attributes of that house, you have enjoyed the results of that house in your earlier life, and hence in this current life the focus is going to be on others. You need to help others, you need to focus on others in the manifestation of the house and what Ketu brings to you. And that is the deeper meaning of Ketu. Obviously there are other aligned meanings also from a spiritual point of view, from a karmic point of view as well. But Ketu's return is more deeper as a warning to us also, as well as an upheaval for us, and it is also like a re-engineering or re-evaluating or resetting of our life in the matters of that house where Ketu is returning, and bases that, bases its aspects also on other attributes of our lives. So Ketu being the planet of negation, Ketu being the planet of doing it for others, Ketu's return is a signal to us of revisiting what we have done so far in the manners of that house. So in a way, Ketu's return is shaking the very foundation of the house and rebuilding. And hence Ketu's return is about rebuilding, it's about re-manifestation and a shake-up, sometimes a huge shake-up where the entire building collapses and a new building has to be erected. Sometimes maybe you need to redo the pillars of the house, which means the roof has to be brought down, and sometimes to a lesser extent the rooms of the house, you know, on a lighter note, have to be rearranged or redone. So wherever Ketu is returning in your horoscope, one needs to focus on that. And what does Ketu's return means, and about what attributes of our lives? It is about revisiting our relations connected to the house where Ketu is placed in, and about the planet which Ketu is placed with. Revisiting our investments, revisiting our actions, revisiting our karma about that house and Ketu's aspects, and to revisit from a learning point of view, and to check and to evaluate whether we have done the respective actions which Ketu denotes or we have done something different. So, if Ketu is placed in the Lagna, it is a revisiting of whether we have focused too much on ourselves and the focus has been less on others. For instance, if Ketu is in the Lagna, Rahu is in the 7th house. Rahu in the 7th house means the focus is more on how much the spouse can do for you and your expectation from the spouse or relationships or in teams or in a partnership are much, much higher from that relationship and you want to contribute less. And hence, you want everything from that partnership, but you don't want to contribute much. And whatever you contribute, you think you have done much more than your share. And whatever the opposite party does, you always feel they have done less. That is what Rahu's dissemination in the 7th houses. So, what does Ketu's placement in the Lagna means? Ketu's placement in the Lagna is a reminder for you that don't be too led by Rahu. The focus by virtue of Rahu placed in the 7th house, in others' house, should be by Ketu in the Lagna, meaning that your focus should be more on others, what you can do for others rather than what others can do for you. And this is in all your interactions, in your relationships, in your teamwork, in your business partnerships and in general. And so Ketu's placement in the Lagna is about you negating things for yourself at a materialistic level, helping others, and the focus should be on helping others to reach a certain position in life, to reach a certain placement into society, and focus less on you chasing materialistic aspects. Ketu in the Lagna doesn't mean a denial of any position or reputation or a certain personality that the general society sees you as. It is not about that. It is that the focus should not be so much on yourself that you are always chasing those attributes for self. For example, if you are not keeping good health, then what do? You may go to an allopathy doctor. If that doctor is not able to help you, you may go to a homeopathic doctor or you may go to Ayurveda. You may try different types of unorthodox medicines as well and different types of practices, even spiritual. Or you may try to do Reiki, you may try to do pranic healing and all sorts of things. So, Ketu in the Lagna is about don't chase so much about health, so much about your personality, so much about your status in life that it is completely negated, which means to be in the best of health where Rahu is placed in the Lagna can give you. Ketu's placement on the Lagna is that even if you have okay health and if you can get along, it is okay. You don't need to focus so much on the self, so much on health or same so much on your own reputation that you forget others. And hence Ketu's placement in the Lagna is more about humility. It's more about practicing humility, keeping the focus on others, keeping the focus away from self, from a materialistic pursuit, and keeping the focus on others, giving more to others, contributing more to others, and doing only so much for yourself that you can sustain. So Ketu's placement in the house is about just about sustenance for yourself, but more to be done for others because you have been there, done that. So if Ketu is returning to your first house, then it is reevaluating, have you practiced humility in the last cycle of Ketu? Now, normally Ketu's return is every 18 years. So, wherever Ketu is placed in your horoscope, the entire transit will take about 18 years and Ketu comes back to the same house, which means that roughly in your life, you can roughly have between 4 Ketu returns, and to very few lucky ones, you may have 5 Ketu returns. Because by the time 4 Ketu returns happen in your life, you have reached the age of 72 already. And the 5th Ketu return, where you have touched 90 years or more, may not come for all of us it may come rarely for others. And by that time, once you cross your 70s, the focus anyways is very less on self. We are just trying to live by, and there may be very less activity in our lives anyway. So we are already in the last, last step of life, if I can use the word. So each of Ketu returns will bring a certain dissemination. So when in your first return, it's about the dharma attributes of life. So what do we do from you when you're born till roughly about your teenage years? You are taught what duties you have, what role you have to play in society, what are your roles and responsibilities, what you need to do, what you should not do. And so you learn how to live life as one of the important contributing members of society. And then comes the Artha period, where your focus is more about how you go about doing your career, what work you are doing, sharpening your skills, getting better on it. And once you establish yourself, then comes the Kama period, which is in your 30s or your mid 30s, where you are trying to solidify your position, you are trying to have stability, you are trying to have more savings, you are trying to have better investments, you are trying to establish your family. And so the next cycle goes all in establishing self, establishing family, establishing children, having a solid career, having solid investments. So that the last phase, by the time it comes, you are settled in life, you are not dependent on others. So each of the karmic returns of Ketu is about the learning for that period. For a teenager, Ketu return means that have you really made a place for yourself in society? Do you really understand how society functions? Do you understand what your specific role is? What kind of a citizen you can be, what kind of a son or daughter you can be, what kind of a sibling you can be, and what kind of a friend you can be, or what kind of a general relations, whether you are a cousin, you are a niece to somebody, you can be. Have you learnt about that? Have you learnt about your duties in society? Have you learnt about your duty to your family and your teachers and your guru? So Ketu's first return is more about a revaluation or relearning or revisiting. Have you learnt all that? Do you know about it? Or have you focused so much on yourself that you have not been able to do anything for any of these relations? You have not understood what your status in society means, how to be a good citizen, how to be a good, how to be a person who can keep relationships and who can sustain relationships or not break off relationships. So each of the Ketu returns will bring in a deeper meaning, will bring in a deeper manifestation and an upheaval. Ketu's return generally shakes up the foundation in the sense that if you have not learnt about that particular return and the attributes of the house where Ketu is placed in and the relationship that Ketu signifies in the matter of which house it is placed in or what planet it is placed with, then Ketu brings in an upheaval, shakes the foundation and negates the results of that house. Sometimes if Ketu is present in your fourth house, for example, the upheaval can be about your property, about land, about your relationship with mother or mother's health, or even mother's continued presence in your life, about your vehicle. So all materialistic collections that you have, the riches that you have, tangible things that you have, all come under the focus where Ketu is returning to the fourth house. It is about have you done your duty to the mother and to that relationship. So Ketu's return is about revisiting and finding out or re-evaluating, have you been true to the relationship, have you been true to the manifestation of the house, have you been dutiful, have you been responsible, how have you been accountable. If you have not been, then Ketu extracts its entire accountability in its return, which means Ketu in a shaking up of the foundation can sometimes wipe off your entire wealth, wipe out that relationship, wipe out the dissemination of the house that it is placed with or about the planet that it is placed with. Sometimes the upheaval may not be to that extent. It may be to a shorter extent where you may be separated from your house, you may be separated from your riches, you may be separated from your family, you may be separated from your mother. Maybe temporarily, but that shake-up may happen. If Ketu is returning to the 10th house, then it could be about career. There could be a huge shake-up in your career, which means that if the upheaval is great, And if you have not focused properly in the dissemination of the 10th house, then maybe you cannot continue in the same industry anymore. You may not find alternate jobs, you may not find an alternate career, you may not find an alternate opening. The entire industry may collapse. Sometimes you may have a bad reputation, sometimes people don't want to work with you. All sorts of upheavals may happen about the 10th house if Ketu is placed in the 10th house, and the upheaval may be to such an extent you have to start all over again. To a lesser extent, the upheaval could be about refocusing your energies in some other direction within the same industry, for example. So I have seen a lot of people, if you are being in the police force, people have maybe retired voluntarily from the police force, start up their security services. If somebody has been a practicing doctor, then maybe you give up your practice and then you start your own hospital, or you're managing your own hospital, for example, or you're moving up the ladder, you're managing a certain department. You're managing, say for example, the orthopedic department or the oncology department, and you are still serving as a doctor, but your responsibilities have grown beyond that. So that kind of an upheaval that Ketu can definitely bring you. But that is more about moving up the ladder. Sometimes if Ketu feels that you have not been true to your career, if you have not been a good doctor, if you have fleeced patients, then the upheaval could be earth shattering. Your entire reputation could be eroded. There could be somebody who levels allegations at you. You may lose your job. You may lose the role that you are in. All sorts of things may happen. And sustaining or even continuation in that career, in that particular industry, may also become a challenge for you. And hence it is a re-evaluation time for you now that Ketu is transiting in Scorpio by the end of this month. So re-evaluate based on your ascendant, whichever house Ketu is going in, re-evaluate how true have you been to the dissemination of the house, to the characteristics of the house, how much have you contributed to others. If you are focused too much on yourself in the matters of that house, you have not been true to the relationship that the house stands for. Say for example, the 5th house is about children, the 9th house is about your father, 9th house is also about gurus. So if Ketu is returning to the 9th house, then it is how much have you invested in higher learning. The higher learning is not only about qualifications and degrees. Higher learning is also about how much have you been able to learn or understand the higher meaning of life. How much have you been able to add more expertise in the line that you are working, not just from a qualification perspective, but experience and more empathy. And if you have not been empathetic, if you have not understood the true meaning of contribution in the matters of that house, how much can you contribute through your higher learning, how much can you contribute to your gurus, how much can you contribute to your father, how much you can respect them, how much you can revisit and go back to them and help them, then Ketu's return to the 9th house could bring in upheaval in those relationships. You could sometimes find that your degrees, your higher learning is not supporting you enough, they are not helping you get a better role in your organization, they are not helping you move up the ladder. Sometimes your degrees are useless because the entire industry has changed or that industry is not relevant anymore. Sometimes you may have fallout with your gurus, with your teachers, or even authority figures at work where your managers are not supporting you anymore. Your higher authority people like your CEO or the managing director or the department heads, they are not on your side, they are not able to appreciate your work, and sometimes even colleagues fall out with you. So that kind of a thing may also come in when Ketu is revisiting your 9th house. I am going to make a separate video about each and every house when Ketu returns to that house, what it means, including Ketu's aspects. This video I am making in as a generic video about what Ketu's return means and how Ketu's results can manifest when it returns, what kind of upheavals it can bring, what kind of answers Ketu is asking you to respond to, and through those answers that you give, you reevaluate what Ketu's return means. So what are these questions that Ketu is asking from you when it returns? The first and most important question that Ketu is asking is, what have you done so far about the house that I am pleased with? And if you remember the video, earlier video that I made about Ketu's aspects, one of the important things that I have laid before you was understanding Ketu's placement from Scorpio energies. Scorpio is co-ruled by Ketu as well as by Mars. So when you look at Ketu's placement, understand that Ketu rules Scorpio, one of the important houses of karma and moksha, and Ketu aspects with its fifth aspect, the 12th house, which is another house of moksha, and with its ninth aspect, the fourth house, which is another house of moksha. So Ketu's placement, Ketu's manifestation is very spiritual. These are moksha bringing, and that's why Ketu brings in those upheavals, because through the experiences that you go through, you are elevating your soul spiritually and moving to the next ladder. And through many such elevations of the soul or moving up many ladders, you eventually reach moksha. So remember that Ketu's placement in the house has those moksha energies, those karma energies with it, which means how much have you done about the attributes of the house to improve your karma? What have you done about that house that your soul can rise spiritually? What have you done to elevate your soul to the next ladder, to the next level? And what have you done to serve the supreme energy through serving the other humanity and manifesting your karma? So that is the first question you need to ask. If Ketu is placed in your second house, what have you done for your immediate family? What have you done about your earnings and your savings? What have you done about your values and your principles? Have you led a life of values? Have you taken care of your immediate family, the house which you were born in, which second house represents, which is your mother and your father and your siblings? Second house is also about food. Ketu placed in the second house means that you need to take care of others. You need to ensure that as many people as possible around you or in your contact or whoever you can reach, you ensure that nobody goes hungry. You need to not use foul language. You need to ensure that you have empathetic approach. You know how to talk to people. You lead your presence in this world through principles, through values, and that is the manifestation. So Ketu is returning to the second house. The question it is asking is, how much of your own earning have you spent for others? How much of the contribution that you have done to keep others away from hunger? How much have you been a family person, taking care of your siblings and your parents? And have you led a life of principles and values? If you have done that and Ketu finds you there, then the road ahead may be some upheavals, or that balance of karma which you have not achieved, the upheaval will be only so much. However, if Ketu finds you that you have not been true to the karma of that house, not been true to the manifestation of the house, then be rest assured the upheaval which could be coming to you in the next 15 to 20 days or maybe about 45 days, that Ketu will settle down in Scorpio, in the sign, that could be a huge shake-up for you. So this means that it is still time for you, wake up and smell the coffee. If you know that Ketu's responsibilities is something which you have not done, you have not practiced humility, you have not been true family person, depending on wherever Ketu is placed in, then immediately first take acceptance. Be submissive to and be humble that you have not done. Beg for forgiveness of that relationship where Ketu is placed with, Ketu denotes, or the planet that Ketu is placed with. If Ketu is placed with Sun, then there is some karmic debt you are carrying about your father. Beg forgiveness from your father or revisit your relationship with your father. See whether you are truly being a good son or not. If Ketu is placed with the Moon, then there is some karmic debt that you are carrying about the mother. And that's why you will find that most of your upheavals, most of your challenges are related to your mother. Most of your run-ins are about your mother. And that is one relation which troubles you all your life. Then it is a time when it comes to revisit the relationship and check how true you have been to the relationship. Or have you contributed if that relationship has gone sour? And wherever Ketu is placed with, check on that relation. If Ketu is placed in the fifth house, then it's about children. If Ketu is placed in the third house, it is about your siblings. If Ketu is placed in the 11th house, it is about general society, your friends, and your elder brother or elder sibling. If Ketu is placed in the fourth house, it is about mother. If Ketu is placed in the 10th house, it is about your supervisors, your managers. If you regularly have a run-in with your managers and supervisors, then there is some karmic debt that you are carrying that from your earlier life as a karmic debt. your entire Sanchita karma could be loaded with that karmic debt, and that is what Ketu is denoting. So Ketu's return is about improving your prarabdha karma about this life and adding to your karma, the better karma, and wiping out at least that particular part of Sanchita karma where Ketu is returning to. So that is the second question that Ketu is asking. The other question that Ketu is asking is, how much of a deeper meaning and understanding of the self that you have? How much understanding have you done about life itself? Do you truly understand the spiritual reason for your presence? What is the purpose of life? What have you come into this world for? What is your aim in life? What is your goal in life? What is the legacy that you are going to leave behind? What will be left behind after you that will carry on as your legacy, as your contribution, and as your continuous contribution to society? If not to the entire society, to an industry. If not to an entire industry, maybe to one part of society, maybe to an NGO, maybe to through a hospital for the sick, maybe to an orphanage, maybe to an educational institution, whatever. What is the legacy that you are going to leave behind? That is the second question that Ketu is asking. What have you done to improve your karma and to take your karma forward? If you have not done that, then there is a challenge. If you know, when you go to a theater, the screen in front of us is the white screen. What does the white screen denote? We know that arts, artistic pursuits, especially related to the media, are related to Rahu. The white screen in front of us, where through a projector where little light is focused on it, but the entire screen reflects the light back, is Rahu. It is that explosion of colors. Ketu, on the other hand, is the black color, and it absorbs the entire results of the house that it is placed with and negates the results of the planet that it is placed with. So how much of a deeper understanding, spiritual understanding, have you had about what is being negated in your life and why it is negated in your life? Why have you been asked to contribute more to others about Ketu's placement? How much of an understanding have you done? How much of a deep meaning and delving into that part have you done? How much have you understood yourself? How much have you understood the purpose of your life? How much of understanding do you have about what legacy you are going to leave behind? And the last part of Ketu's placement is resetting the context. Resetting the context means looking back in your entire life so far. Say for example, if you are born in the Ketu Dasha itself. So every Dasha that you are born in, there is a deeper meaning to why you have been born in that Dasha. How do you calculate which Dasha you are born in? Wherever moon is placed in your horoscope, whichever nakshatra the moon is placed in, the lord of the nakshatra will be the first dasha that you are born in. Moon is the manas, moon is also the heart. So it moon is both the mind and the heart, and moon's placement in a nakshatra, and that's dasha, has a deeper manifestation meaning to it. I will be doing a video separately on what is the meaning of the dasha that you are born in. So if you are born in a Ketu dasha, and a lot of things being born in the dasha are being negated to you, how much of a deep dive and delving into the meaning of your purpose of your life from that house have you been able to see? And from there onwards, what you have been able to achieve? So resetting the context also is, what are you going to do from now on? So through the lessons that the Ketu return is bringing to you, the upheaval that Ketu is bringing to you, the chance that Ketu is bringing to you, the re-engineering that Ketu is doing for you, or to you, or to the manifestations of the house that it is returning to you, through that Ketu is saying that reset the context and decide now from now on what you are going to do, where you are going to move, where you are going to focus, how you are going to focus, and are you from now on at least going to be true to Ketu's manifestation, to the purpose of life, and to the legacy that you are going to leave behind. Ketu in a larger sense represents you. Why you? Because we have not come into this world to do something for ourselves. It is the higher duty that we have to the general humanity, and through serving the humanity, serving the supreme energy. And hence Ketu represents you, which means we need to have a life of denial more of the material pursuits, and acceptance and working towards the karmic and the spiritual pursuits. how much have you understood that, and where are you leading from now on towards that karma? How much are you focusing on improving your karma? How much are you focusing on letting go of the karmic debt so that you can elevate in this life itself to the next ladder in your spiritual pursuits? That is the resetting the context that Ketu is asking of you. If you have still not learned the lesson, then you can look forward to a big upheaval in your life in the manner of, or in the matters of the house that Ketu is placed with. If Ketu is in the second house and if you have not learned the lesson, I have seen the entire savings, the entire earnings of people's lives wiped out in an instance within a few months maybe. Sometimes the entire family goes away from them, negates them, the entire family is angry with them or leaves them. So take this opportunity. You still have around 10 or more days to go for the Ketu transit to happen into Scorpio. So understand what your ascendant is, understand where Ketu is placed in the respective horoscope, what are the aspects on Ketu, what are the planets Ketu is placed with, understand Ketu's meanings deeply. I have made other videos about Ketu's placement, about Ketu Dasha also. Look into those videos, have a deeper meaning of Ketu, and from now on in the next 45 days or so, look forward to resetting the context, resetting your life. So look into your horoscopes, understand Ketu's returns, what it means, and all the best to you to reset your life from now on and to move up the ladder spiritually. So friends, like this video, please share this video, and if you are looking for a personal consultation for me, please reach out to me at the links given below. And till some other time with some other video, this is your friend, astrologer and guide Irfan signing off. Ciao.